football has completely lost its soul. Football was never set up to be a multi-million pound business, and as soon as you start treating it like a business, you lose the heart of the game. Football in itself isn't interesting. 22 people kicking a ball around is not an interesting thing. It's the thing that makes football interesting is what it means to people. That's why I always love football projects that I see that are using football to express something deeper, to express a sense of who people are. Everyone is equal. Everyone should be able to play football. And everyone's football is as important as everyone else's football.
Ulaanbaatar s'enfonce dans l'automne, gercé par le froid. Mais pour le FC Bayangol, un club de la ville, c'est soir de fête.
This is from the league. We won the third. We were in the third place in the second division of Mongolian Football Federation League. And the trophy is for the amateur cup.
Ces réjouissances sont teintées d'une présence incongrue.
Hi, everyone. It's really nice to be back and see all of you guys. I know it was not always the easiest season, and it was quite a lot of difficulties for us to deal with, but I was very proud and impressed with the way that all of you approached the season and with the results that we got.
Troisième d'un championnat de deuxième division à 8 équipes, le FC Bayangol a échoué cet été à un souffle de la promotion.
Obviously, we were one goal away from being promoted, but still, that was an incredible achievement from every one of you. And in 2 years, we've come from not even having a club to having the fastest growing club in Mongolia. I believe we can be one of the best clubs in Mongolia. And I hope you'll join me in a toast to Bayangol.
Qui est donc cet Anglais venu créer un club en Mongolie? Que cherche ce missionnaire du football en terrain inconnu?
This is what football should look like, and then when we start doing the vodka shots, that's probably less like what football should look like.
Peut-il vraiment bâtir en Mongolie un football débarrassé de ses excès? Sa route débute il y a 6 ans. Une banale discussion avec son colocataire va propulser Paul Watson au bout du monde.
We'd reached a point where we were obsessed with football. We spent our whole lives being obsessed with football. Over a short period, came up with this pretty stupid idea that was that we would find the weakest national football team in the world, qualify to play for them by naturalizing, and then we would get this dream that we'd always had of being, you know, international footballers. And what started as a sort of conversation you might have as a joke in the pub ended up being something a bit more serious.
Ce sera donc la Micronésie, un minuscule archipel aux confins du Pacifique. Les deux hommes abandonnent leur travail, empruntent de l'argent et quittent Londres, remplis d'espoir.
We got to this field and there was a sort of rotted running track, grass up to your knees almost, puddles everywhere, and just across on the other side of the pitch is one kid in an England shirt.
Ce délabrement sera leur socle. En 2 ans, ils développent le football sur une terre que ce sport avait désertée.
This time, we have a corner, so we're all going to move up to our corner positions.
Sur une île où 60% de la population est obèse, jouer au football est désormais une fierté.
Suddenly, it didn't seem so important to go back to a dinner party and say we played a game for an island. When you've been on the island and looked these people in the eye and sort of seen they don't need people coming over and taking advantage of them. What they need is someone to stand up and try and give them an opportunity. So I think in a way, this project made a lot of sense, even though it seemed quite crazy to most people.
Quand vient l'heure de rentrer chez soi, surgit alors une nouvelle péripétie.
I received an email from a guy called Enki Batsumer.
Technical director is here.
Enki Batsumer travaille à la Fédération mongole de football. En 2013, il découvre l'aventure de Paul en Micronésie à travers un article de journal et parvient à le convaincre de venir créer un projet en Mongolie.
We started from blank page. The idea of club was the right way to go. We thought reality show of making the starting the club and doing the tryouts would be a great idea.
Something special is happening in Mongolian soccer.
Paul se rend donc en Mongolie pour superviser le recrutement de son nouveau club. Là encore, le football n'est qu'un prétexte.
Maybe it means more to have identity here than the football itself for me. You know, the club where you can support and be proud of.
L'initiative est un succès qui colore même des destins difficiles à soupçonner. Ochuro a 18 ans. Il fut l'un des premiers joueurs recrutés par le club. Au creux de ses sacrifices, la même obsession que des millions d'enfants. Et si l'universalité du football trouvait sa définition dans l'aube d'Oulan-Bator? Même dans cette yourte, ces 10 mètres carrés où il vit avec sa famille, ce sport a agrippé Ochuro et l'a placé sur la route d'un jeune Anglais.
Mais
susciter des vocations ne suffit pas quand on veut développer le football en Mongolie.
There are a few huge obstacles. One is, of course, the weather. You know, this is not even November yet, and we can't play outside now. It's too cold.
What are the worst temperatures, for example?
Minus 30, minus 40, you know.
Pendant 8 mois, jouer au football dehors est donc inenvisageable. Mais au-delà du climat, le FC Bayangol se heurte à d'autres écueils. Un simple terrain public ouvert à tous, en guise de centre d'entraînement.
Il
C'est dans ce cadre détonnant qu'il faut quand même trouver des raisons d'y croire. Sous-peser l'ampleur du chantier. Ce soir-là, Paul a rendez-vous avec les deux entraîneurs de son club pour faire avancer son projet.
Hey. Hi. How you doing? Good to see you.
Hey.
Même s'il veut s'éloigner du football business, affleure très vite un mot central, l'argent.
How much money per month do you think would a player need to be professional, proper?
$200.
For us, it's good to know how much is needed so we can try.
$200 per month.
You have 20 players. It's really high.
It's quite high. And how about for you as a coach?
It's really high.
Fair enough.
Dans l'immédiat, il y a encore plus vital.
We use UBU equipment all the time.
Do we?
Balls, beeps, cones.
Sometimes fields.
Fields.
Yeah.
So if we can get sort that out as well. I used to have some equipment, but after last year, it disappeared.
It does
some
disappear.
Some went to some players.
How do you order? Do you buy it from China here?
Yeah, we can buy it from China.
Is that the cheapest?
It's cheapest.
China.
Really expensive is balls.
Futsal or just normal?
Both.
No, we don't have any both.
Okay, so we don't own any footballs. Yeah, we'll get some footballs. Shit.
Энэ бол яг Монголын клубүүдийн сонирхчийн гэлтгүй ер нь клубүүдийн хувьд анх удаа ийм одоо өөрийнхөө сонирхол дур сонирхлоор ирж Монголд баг байгуулж тэр баг анги амжилтанд хүргэсэй гэж хамаг ажиллаа зориулж байгаа болохоор би одоо Полд бол маш их баярлаа гэж хэлмээр байна.
Les problèmes cernés. Il faut désormais y remédier. Et cela passe parfois par d'improbables chemins.
70-80% of electricity of the central Mongolia, not the city, the central area, and 70-80% of heat is also generated here.
I should have been repeated for in company, giving the support.
En Mongolie, les choses du football se jouent parfois à l'ombre d'une centrale électrique.
We're looking to create a partnership with the biggest club in the country, Etchim, in the power plant here, because we don't have the infrastructure that we need as a club. We don't have a training facilities. This is sort of like the Old Trafford of Mongolia. La circonstance se prête aux propositions enrobées de compliments. At Etchim, they have obviously the best club in the country and very talented players. And perhaps what we can bring is an appeal to the European awareness. I want to see Mongolian football develop, and I think as a goal for there to be at least one Mongolian player in a major European league would be a massive step forward.
Visiblement, l'exposé a plu, la récompense est à portée de fenêtre.
Ah, that's the pitch.
Do you see the pitch?
Yeah, I see the pitch.
That's brilliant.
Ажлагтай хэдэн байж байгаа бас тэгээ яаж энэ ямар хөөсөд
Un terrain entretenu à leur entière disposition, accueilli comme une bénédiction.
We have very limited resources at this stage. They've certainly got something here that we could never dream of having within, you know, 5-10 years. This is a crucial, a really crucial step for us. It's one of the most striking stadiums that I've ever been in. Like, at once the most beautiful and the most ugly.
Il reste toutefois des réticences farouches à balayer. La preuve, dans un bar de supporters de Manchester United, un soir de derby.
Do you prefer watching Premier League or Mongolian football?
Of course, Premier League.
Yes, same here. We prefer English football. Because it's simply fantastic.
You support Manchester United, but do you support also a club from your city?
There's no good team in Mongolia. Most of the guys from Mongolia prefer football from abroad.
I don't even know who play in our league.
Mais comment faire pour lutter contre cette fascination exclusive?
They feel this obvious close affinity with Manchester, but they don't feel that same affinity with teams that are from their own city, which seems strange to me. It's quite sad in its own way, but I suppose it's our job to do something that really gets these people inspired and whips them up. We're not kidding anyone. We're not going to become, these players aren't going to become as famous or as good as these Manchester United players, but it's a hard thing to change, and it's step by step. You know, 2 years ago, we didn't even have a club. Now we have a club with players who I really trust and who I like. Maybe in 2 years' time, we'll have a club with players who can come into a bar like this and get a standing ovation.
Cet attrait pour l'ailleurs et sème jusque dans la yourte d'Otchuro.
Утгуу гадагшаа авч мэрэгжлийн гэрээ байгуулад тэгээ тэндээ маш их сайжраад яг л өөрийнхөө мөрөөдснөр Манчестер Юнайтедийн өмсгөлтөд Олд Траффорд цэнгэлдүүлэнд гарч ирэхэд
Apparemment, le rêve n'est plus si loin.
Одоо ер нь яг одоо бол байгаа л да. Тэгээд яг одоо Los Angeles Galaxy нөгөө Америкийн бүгд тэгээд сайн энэ сарын өмнө над нэг санал ирсэн. Сорилт одоо сорилтонд орох уу, нөөц багт орох уу гэд. Одоо надтай агент хөлбөмбөгийн агент холбогдсон. Molo Brian гэд. Тэгээд тэр хүн болохоор өөрөө Los Angeles одоо агентээр ажилладаг.
Mais cette proposition a quelque chose d'extrêmement inhabituel.
Тэр одоо энэ гисэн бохгүй. Гэрээг явуулсан. Гэрээтэй тэгээ танилцаад чи үлэн зөвшөөрч ивэл гарын үсгийг зураад эцэгхийн гарын үсгийг зураад тэгээд мэйлэр явуулдаг гэсэн. Би болохоор одоо жишээ нь нөгөө юуны гэрээний одоо нөгөө $2,500 гэж төссөн. Хүмүүс зээлэл тийм тэгээд олоод өгсөн.
Ce qui était le plus beau des espoirs vire au désastre.
Чи натруу дэрэг ярихгүй байсан юм. Ха? Ер нь ингэдэг байхгүй юу? Ийм их хүн би чамд хэлж байгаа шүү дээ. Амар их байдаг. Аа, энэ хүний мөнгө аваад тэтгэнэс шалгалч. Тэгэл ийм хүн ингээд энэ хүний зургийг ашиглал профайл нэг чинь хин байл. Монголоор чамд хэрэгцээдсэн юм
уу? Үгүй, хань л.
Le club va te donner une prime à la signature de $30,000. Ils ont besoin que tu ouvres un compte pour te virer l'argent. Donc, je vais m'en occuper. Le club va t'envoyer tes billets d'avion. Et surtout, l'argent va arriver sur ton compte.
D'accord, vous êtes mon sauveur et mon espoir. Je vais vous envoyer l'argent maintenant. Je l'ai emprunté à plusieurs personnes depuis 3 jours. Ma mère est enceinte et elle est malade, mais elle ne peut pas être soignée. Il faut que je réussisse. Je crois tellement en vous.
Notre enquête va confirmer ses craintes. Moll O'Brien n'existe pas. Le truand a créé un faux compte Facebook en utilisant les photos d'un vrai joueur brésilien, Luis Fabiano Rodriguez. En tout, Ochuro enverra plus de 6 000 $ aux faux agents, quand le salaire moyen en Mongolie avoisine les 250 $ par mois. Son argent, Ochuro ne le reverra jamais.
This is pretty much the worst thing that can, one of the worst things that can happen for a, when you deal with a young player. And you feel like you failed in some way by letting this happen, but and you probably maybe have, but it's just that these people are out there and they prey on kids with dreams, which is a pretty bad thing to do. But we will do absolutely everything that we can do.
C'est donc l'esprit embrumé qu'il faut reprendre la route de son idéal.
We still don't know whether we can get this guy. Somebody has to stop this guy.
Somebody's got to stop him.
2h30 de trajet depuis Ulaanbaatar pour encore propager le football. À Baganor, ville de mineurs dans l'est du pays, le FC Bayangol est venu diffuser un peu de son savoir-faire.
It's sort of symbolic of the fact that our, hopefully, our Bayangol project is for the whole of Mongolia. It's not just for a small group of people in the capital. And we're hoping we can sort of involve people across the whole country, but the challenges are pretty enormous.
Il faut donc composer, naviguer entre l'émerveillement des uns et le souvenir de la détresse des autres. S'interroger surtout sur la possibilité d'une utopie, ce football pur au bout du monde.
It's really sad to sort of come across the very worst of football and the fact that even in a place like this, in sort of a little gare in Ulaanbaatar, this ugly side of the game can get in there and claim its victims. And it's a battle that's going on across the world, really.